You're watching ESPN's coverage of Ramada Worldwide Bracket Busters from Charles Koch Arena here in Wichita, Kansas. It's the Detroit Titans from the Horizon League challenging the Wichita State Shockers out of the Missouri Valley Conference. Due to time constraints, we are moving ahead in our coverage. You're watching ESPN's coverage of Ramada Worldwide Bracket Busters from Charles Koch Arena here in Wichita, Kansas. The Detroit Titans from the Horizon League facing the Wichita State Shockers of the Missouri Valley Conference. We move ahead in our action right after these messages. You're watching ESPN's coverage of Ramada Worldwide Bracket Busters. It's halftime here in Wichita, the Detroit Titans and the Wichita State Shockers. ESPN College Basketball is available live anytime, anywhere on your computer, tablet, or smartphone. You're watching ESPN's coverage of Ramada Worldwide Bracket Busters. It's halftime here in Wichita, the Detroit Titans and the Wichita State Shockers. ESPN College Basketball is available live anytime, anywhere on your computer, tablet, or smartphone at watchespn.com and with a Watch ESPN app. More action after this. It's halftime here in Wichita, the Detroit Titans and the Wichita State Shockers. ESPN College Basketball is available. You're watching ESPN's coverage of Ramada Worldwide Bracket Busters. It's halftime here in Wichita, the Detroit Titans and the Wichita State Shockers. ESPN College Basketball is available live anytime, anywhere on your computer, tablet, or smartphone at watchespn.com and with a Watch ESPN app. More action after this.
Came in and played harder, and they came out of here with a victory. Seniors, you get four of you guys are starting. Give it the example for everyone else. Make sure that these people that know when they come in the game, the example's been set. You got two more times to play in front of the best crowd in the country. Two more times. This and next Wednesday. Okay? And let's make it count. Let's go.
Let's go. Go.
Let's go. 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 Family on three. One, two, three. Family. Go. Okay? And number four, play harder. Play harder than them. It'll be hard for them to come in and get a victory here, despite what people predict what's going to happen. It's going to be very hard for them to get a victory if they don't play hard. One time, all year, somebody came in and played harder, and they came out of here with a victory. Seniors, you get four of you guys are starting. Give it the example for everyone else. Make sure that these people that know when they come in the game, the example's been set. You got two more times to play in front of the best crowd in the country. Two more times. This and next Wednesday. Okay? And let's make it count. Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Family on three. One, two, three. okay? And number four, play harder. Play harder than them. It'll be hard for them to come in and get a victory here, despite what people predict what's going to happen. It's going to be very hard for them to get a victory if they don't play hard. One time, all year, somebody came in and played harder, and they came out of here with a victory. Seniors, you get four of you guys are starting. Give it the example for everyone else. Make sure that these people that know when they come in the game, the example's been set. You got two more times to play in front of the best crowd in the country. Two more times. This and next Wednesday. Okay? You must make it count. Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Family on three. One, two, three, seven. Go.
Welcome back. This is ESPN's coverage of Ramada Worldwide Bracket Busters. What an interesting afternoon we are having in Wichita, Kansas, inside Coke Arena. A high-scoring game, Darren Horn, and it's very surprising. As much as we expected Wichita State to be the grinded-out team, they're getting layup after layup, like Dickie V said that one time, after layup.
Well, it's sort of a flipped in the scripts where we expected Detroit to put up the big numbers, and Wichita State's been able to do it with 46 in the first half.
And before the game, we had an opportunity to visit with Greg Marshall with our cameras in there, and he talked about what would separate Wichita State from Detroit should they be effective this afternoon. Let's listen.
Okay. And number four, play harder. Play harder than them. It'll be hard for them to come in and get a victory here, despite what people predict was going to happen. It's going to be very hard for them to get a victory if they don't play hard. One time, all year, somebody came in and played harder, and they came out of here with a victory. Seniors. You get four of you guys are starting. Give it the example for everyone else. Make sure that these people that know when they come in the game, the example's been set. You got two more times to play in front of the best crowd in the country. Two more times. This and next Wednesday. Okay? And let's make it count. Let's go.
And this is how they did it, Darren. This is the Wichita State philosophy.
Well, did they hustle? It's what their program's built on, and they did it with 50-50 balls. That's a ball that can go either way. You see Van Vliet getting on the floor. They came up with more of those than Detroit, and they did it by getting out in transition and outworking them, running the floor on offense and getting some easy baskets. The 50-50 balls, the effort in transition, out-hustling them, as Greg Marshall said. That's why they're up at half and have put 46 on the board.
And you see the numbers here, 8 of 9 players with at least a rebound, 4 blocks, 3 steals, a bunch of layups, are shooting 55.9%. They also have a dozen assists and just 3 turnovers, and those turnovers were in the first, I don't know, minute and a half of the game. They haven't turned the ball over in probably 20 minutes of basketball. Nice pass to Bruinsma. And Minerath sets him up nicely.
Well, that's what you want if you're Detroit coming out of the half. You want to get something attacking the basket. Nice finish by Bruinsma.
So Demetric Williams in some trouble, gets tied up. He wants a timeout. It's going to be a jump ball instead. The possession arrow, however, favors the Shockers. So for Wichita State, Carl Hall is on the floor. So is Malcolm Armstead, number 2. Hall, 22. Arupe, 21, the big center. And to Kale Cotton, 32. That's Hall. Armstead, a great first half. A little pressure here now from Detroit, but wide open 3-ball. Demetric Williams sort of forgotten in that corner. McCallum on the give and go kick ball. He was trying to give it to Anderson, and Lord knows what was going to happen if Anderson had a chance to dunk again. So on the floor for the Titans, Ray McCallum, Jason Calise, number 10, 33, Evan Bruinsma, 34, Nick Minerath, and 23, Doug Anderson again. Bruinsma getting the start as Calise misses. Over Juwan Howard Jr., who is missing today's game after suffering a tailbone injury in practice. Williams, step back. And didn't hit anything, and Calise bounced it off the leg. That's not going to sell well here, but I think it was off of a repay.
Well, nice call right there.
Wait a minute. Darren Horn, former coach, could be a coach again one day, just complimented an official.
Because I'm going to win this game either way, regardless of how they call the game.
Yeah, your record as a coach this year has been, you're undefeated.
They're a lot friendlier to me, too, now, by the way.
I was going to ask you about that. I'm sure you get looks every once in a while, though.
I like what Detroit's doing early here offensively in the second half, getting some movement, attacking the basket.
Anderson, I don't know if he meant to do it quite that way, but he was able to get that rather an odd-looking tip in.
Well, didn't look pretty, but a great look from the top by your best player, so Detroit will take that anytime down the court.
Box score doesn't count degree of difficulty. Arupe. Blocked by Bruinsma, and we're going to have a foul. Here are some of the numbers from the first half, and Wichita State shooting continuing to do well. And another thing that's interesting, Darren, is 56%, but only 2 of 9 from 3.
Well, because they got so many easy ones around the basket, and the other number that jumps out at you is 20 bench points and 0 from Detroit. One of the strengths of this Wichita State team is their depth. They don't miss a beat when they sub in off the bench. In fact, their leading scorer comes in off the bench and early.
And that is Klee Anthony early. But now the problem for Ray McCallum, the Detroit head coach, is that Bruinsma, starting for Howard, has three fouls. And Detroit not as deep as Wichita State.
And this may be one of those games where you're going to have to play somebody with three fouls, maybe a little more than you would like to if they get foul trouble.
So Bruinsma is going to have to watch it on the defensive end. One out of two for Arupe. McCallum. They thought about going inside. Bruinsma is going to tee up and nail a three. He is a 28% three-point shooter, and Bruinsma hits that one.
I like Bruinsma. He's a young guy that gets to the glass, gives effort on the defensive end, and now knocking down the shot, trying to be like Minerath.
The least off the turnover. Bruinsma will try again. And Anderson getting the rebound. So Detroit trying to elbow their way back into this game. You were at Valpo last week when you saw Detroit make a big second half comeback to take a game on the road in the Horizon League.
Down 15 points against a veteran Valpo team inside 10 minutes, and they get the victory. Can't count these guys out because of their ability to score, and they've got big play.
Ooh,
Ray McCallum
Minerath
at all times.
How about that? McCallum off the pass to Minerath, and we're going to get a timeout, I think, called by Greg Marshall of Wichita State. No one officials time. Let's see if we had a timeout called by Wichita State. I think it was our referee, Paul Zelick, going to the table and trying to determine whether or not the shot by Minerath is a two or a three. The initial ruling was a three.
You know, we talked about how dangerous Detroit is offensively, and one of the reasons is how many different guys they have that can knock down the three. We know about Kalist, we know about Ray McCallum. But the last two threes that have gone in have been 2 6-9 guys stepping out beyond the arc. And now we've got a two-possession game. Can't count this Detroit team out at any time because of how potent they are on the offensive end.
Well, I don't know if Detroit's going to make the NCAA tournament. They're going to have to fight their way in on the Horizon League. They may have to win out and win the league to make it. Wichita State, their chances look pretty good. Either of these teams will be a load in the tournament for somebody to handle.
They would be a nightmare matchup. You see one of these teams come up and you're the opposing coach, you do the smile for the Selection Sunday show.
Oh, yeah.
And then you go into your office and you get sick thinking about how you have to play against them.
The ruling on the court stood as a three. So Detroit now within five. Hall, offensive foul, offensive foul.
I think that was a good call if he was outside of the charge arc around the basket.
Now let's take a look at it. That's the first foul on Hall, the first on the Shockers in the half.
Nice rotation by Kalist. He is outside of it. Good call, good play. Now you see Detroit starting to get some of those stops and taking away those easy layups.
Well, their defense is clearly better in the opening minutes of this second half. Minerath missed everything that time, and coming away with it is Williams. This is the closest we've been since it was 21-16 with 9:05 to go in the first half. And the shooting from Malcolm Armstead continues. Wow.
How big has Malcolm Armstead been so far today? Every time Wichita State needed a bucket, the seniors stepped up.
That's his first three of the afternoon. He's got 13. McCallum, tough shot. And tapped right back out of bounds, and McCallum should have gone after that. It was tapped out of bounds by the Titans. Surprised to see him not chase that one down. Substitution for Detroit, Jermaine Lippert, a junior. Born in Germany, and Minerath will check out. Interesting, Bruinsma stays on the floor with the three fouls. Minerath might be a little bit gassed.
Well, one of the things that turned it offensively in the first half for Wichita State was when Armstead started getting some dribble penetration, some of that off of ball screen action. Let's see if they look to get him involved that way now.
Armstead, nice pass to Cotton, and knocked out of bounds by Bruinsma with 19. Well, a secret weapon today for Wichita State. You got Klee Anthony early off the bench who can score. Hall can score inside, and it's Armstead from the outside. And the Shockers lead by eight. This bracket buster. There's your score and time here at Koch Arena on the campus of Wichita State University with Darren Horn. I'm Dave Lamont. We were talking about the Titans and the Shockers. Should they make the tournament? Detroit, they got some work to do.
Well, the schedule strength is good, not great, but the BPI and the RPI not outstanding for them. They've got some good wins against Akron and Valpo, but came up empty against Syracuse.
So we were asking you on Twitter, which 2013 Bracket Busters team is most likely to step up and make some noise in the NCAA tournament? And your chance to vote, results revealed tonight at 8 o'clock Eastern in that South Dakota State-Murray State game on ESPN2. Now, A, Akron, B, Creighton, C, Wichita State, D, other Bracket Buster team. Now, so somebody, St. Mary's?
St. Mary's is a definite possibility, but they're going to have to get a good win.
Well, they get a shot at Creighton. Wichita State gets another layup. And back to a double-digit advantage. Klee Anthony early with 13 points. McCallum. And an and-one opportunity. Hall argues the call briefly, but that's not going to make any difference.
Well, Ray McCallum doing a tremendous job with his team in the second half. Coach Ray McCallum getting them settled down, making sure they move the basketball, that they attack off of movement. Nice curl off the stagger screen by the young Ray McCallum with a chance at the end one.
Well, Dad could play a little bit too. Second foul on early. And no problem. They were yelling, Daddy's boy.
They can chant Daddy's boy all they want, Dave. He's the best player in the gym.
NBA guy, McCallum?
No question. First-round draft pick.
But when is the issue? He is a junior. Or does he come back and play one more?
I think if he went this year, he has a good chance to be a first-rounder. He's a point guard with size that can score and create for others. Draft's not especially strong this year.
When you say first round, of course, it's almost like two first rounds. There's lottery, and then there's the first round. Where does he fit there?
I think it would be towards the end of the first round right now. I wouldn't call him a lottery, but he's going to play at the next level for sure.
Well, the thing that's nice about him is you see father and son having a chat, is that he's the kind of point guard that doesn't have to shoot to be happy. He will make other people happy.
There's no question about it, and he's got almost a 3-to-1 assist turnover ratio. 2-to-1 is really good. 3-to-1 is incredible, but he can get his own shot. And he's athletic enough at that level to be able to play and compete on both ends and do the things you have to be a good point guard in the NBA.
Hall missed the first of the two free throws. Detroit hanging around in this game. They were down by 11 at the half, and Hall missed them both. What a rebound by Early. Hall fighting for it, but Bruinsma gets it, and here come the Titans.
Well, one of the things Wichita State wanted to do coming into this game was take away Ray McCallum's left-hand drive. That's two straight buckets going to the left for a big play.
Armstead goes lefty. He gets hammered. Interesting. Wichita State goes back to the guy who's been their best offensive player today. And Armstead will go to the line. McCallum hit with his first foul of the day and the first on Detroit. Well, we talk about the NBA. You might see Ray McCallum in there one day. We've got triple header on ABC and ESPN coming up. Some interesting games as always. We have a lot of Bracket Busters basketball yet to be played. We mentioned Creighton St. Mary's tonight. You're going to see Ohio out of the MAC and Belmont. Belmont's another one of those teams that you do the smile and then you go, oh, no, when you get them in your draw.
Well, Rick Byrd, longtime coach at Belmont, outstanding coach. They've got a tremendous program. And they're another one of those nightmare matchups come March.
It is an obvious thing to say, but that's what I do, is how wide open this year's NCAA tournament is going to be. Steal. Armstead. Early couldn't get the follow, and Minerath secures the rebound. Wow. Two fabulous looks at the basket. McCallum goes the other way. He's fouled. Nope, I thought I heard a whistle. No foul. There is a basket. Could have sworn I heard a whistle. McCallum goes to the right side. And Armstead is fouled again. Well, this game is getting crazy. Fourth on Bruinsman. Well, McCallum can fly, apparently.
Well, nice pass. And you see the athleticism, another reason this guy's an NBA guard. He's got the athleticism to make plays like that. But how about Armstead on the other end, Dave, doing his own athletic play, getting to the rim. Really been the difference offensively for Wichita State throughout this game.
Well, there aren't a lot of point guards that can dunk. Russell Westbrook comes to mind immediately, but that's not part of the game for a point guard, but it certainly doesn't hurt.
It's a nice added bonus when they can.
Wow. All right. But still, Wichita State steals another one. Early.
There's two bad things that come with that play. One, a bucket for Wichita State, but if you're Detroit, it gets this crowd into it as well.
That doesn't hurt either. A solid rejection by Arupe. Great execution. Minerath off the screen, curls in a three, and a timeout called by Detroit. Racket Buster game living up to the expectations of those who thought it was going to be a good one. It is. Hayward. Man, is he lighting it up. Well, Bracket Busters is always a good time for all. Some folks come in disguise, but at Wichita State, they're having a great time with their team in front. Now, Bracket Busters has had some incredible talent. Guys who've gone on to the NBA, Steph Curry, wonderful shooter at Davidson, Gordon Hayward at Butler, ninth overall pick, Damian Lillard. Holy smokes.
Is tremendous rookie season.
Amazing. Got to be the rookie of the year. But Darren Horn was dissatisfied with the efforts of our staff, and you came up with your own.
I don't know how you leave these three guys out. Kyle Korver, look at his performance in the Bracket Buster game. That was the first ever on TV, one of the best shooters in the league. Norris Cole, outstanding college player at Cleveland State. He's got a world championship ring. And Kenneth Faried, who played for my man Donnie Tindall while at Morehead State, he's a double-double machine. And he did it in college as well in Bracket Busters.
Now, Faried's one of my favorite players in the NBA. I always enjoy watching him play. has everything from head to toe. Effort, smarts, the whole bit. He's Darren Horn. I'm Dave Lamont. We welcome you inside Wichita State, the famed Cook Arena. And the freshman, Fred Van Vliet, continuing to play really well off the bench.
The future is bright at Wichita State. This young man's going to be an outstanding player in the Missouri Valley.
Trying to go to McCallum. Boutte into the game now for Detroit. So they've gone small, and Edwards, that's only a layup. Disappointing his many fans who were hoping for something more flashy.
Well, but it counts the same. Detroit continues their second half trend of good execution and taking better shots.
And a little bit better defense, although they gave up the easy layup that time. But their defense was not good at all in the first half. Wichita State shot well over 50%.
One of the challenges as a coach in this situation, Dave, is you get it down to two possessions, then can you get it down to one? But then your team has to get some stops. They've got to find a way to get some key stops. The scoring has been there, but they haven't gotten the stops they need in the second half to try to get the lead.
Darren, what's interesting is now both teams have gone a little smaller. McCallum, good patience. And a friendly touch on the road. Now the biggest players out there are Minerath at 6'9". For Detroit and Hall at about 6'7". So with Bruinsma out of the game, Detroit went small with the third guard. And Wichita State matched it. Hall. Just fighting. Didn't get it that time, though. Edwards.
Detroit with the 50-50 balls.
McCallum. Anderson had his hands in the air right there to celebrate the three-pointer. Look at this score now. Wichita State had a double-digit lead for much of the first half.
How about Ray McCallum with 21 points? He's turned it on when his team needed it most. That's what special players do, Dave.
Van Vliet, open look for three. Nick Wiggins, guard from Toronto, a 44% three-point shooter. And the steal, lack of concentration that time. Alley-oop! Look out here with Anderson. I think as a basketball fan, I would have enjoyed another spectacular dunk. We've had a couple in this game. Van Vliet. And Hall will follow up. Nobody boxed out Hall. How do you not do that? How about this score? Tipped out of bounds, hit the official who's part of the floor. It will belong to Detroit.
Wichita State getting it done on the defensive end. That's not always pretty, but this one was, the dunk by Early.
Down the street at 25 45 minutes, the other 40 grand compliance will be guaranteed lowest prices. All right, gentlemen, thank you very much. There is a reputation for the Ramada Worldwide Bracket Busters for exciting games, and this is turning into one, and Ray McCallum has a lot to do with that.
Well, Ray McCallum is a special player, and what he's doing in this half is what special players do. Step up big when his team needs him most. He's done it off dribble penetration and finishing at the rim. He's done it with high-flying athletic plays, and he's done it with knocking down the perimeter jumper as well. And what I like about it, Dave, is you see the percentage there, 5 for 7. He does it efficiently. This is not a guy that needs high volume to put up big numbers.
Well, he's the ultimate point guard. He knows how to keep the team happy, and yet he knows when it's time for him to step in and take shots. Minerav. Brother. He has started to find the stroke from the outside. Off the assist by McCallum. Minerav with 21. Tough shot by Williams. And rebound going, well. How many bodies there? Five?
Wichita State
has called a timeout. There are times you watch a football game, you don't see that many guys go after a fumble.
Well, it had to be six. I wasn't a math major, but there were four standing. So you got six guys on the floor.
Wow. This is, by the way, a non-conference game now. There's no conference pride at stake or conference seating or anything like that. These are teams that are playing, obviously, to set themselves up maybe for the NCAA tournament. Wichita State has been a remarkable record this year with 23 wins, not having all of their players either. And Greg Marshall didn't start the year with what he had last year when they won so many games and went to the NCAA tournament.
Well, the impressive thing is they lost a lot from last year, but the third part of the graphic there, they've missed three starters from this season's team for most of the year. They still got off to the best start in school history and are sitting on 23 wins. It's a credit to their commitment to the identity of their program, which is toughness and rebounding and defense.
Wessel and Baker. Now, Wessel's done for the season. He's going to take a redshirt. Baker has been working out as Hall will get the easy layup off the assist. And Baker, there is some hope here that he will return for Arch Madness, the MVC tournament. And arguably the best name for any tournament I've ever heard of in my life. It's in St. Louis. Boutte, Minerath, he's hot. Not that time, and Hall corrals the rebound with Boutte, the smallest player on the floor at the moment, pestering him, but not getting it.
Well, with foul trouble for Detroit, Wichita State.
Hall!
Gone to a little bit of pressure because McCallum is not handling the basketball as much.
He had to avoid stepping on Minerath, who had been knocked over. And now some pressure. Why do you think McCallum isn't handling the ball as much?
Well, they've gone small, and the other guys have to be able to bring it up so that then they can get the ball back to Ray after it's moved a little bit. Hasn't happened the last two possessions.
Offensive rebound by Minerath to McCallum. Missed it. Fouled. That'll be on Clay Anthony Early, his second. Third, pardon me. Now three.
Detroit may need to put in the Ray rule, Dave, which says no one shoots until Ray touches it first.
I just find it odd that he's kind of a small forward right now. He's sort of playing the three position.
Well, Berensma coming back into the game here at the next break. I have an opportunity to get him back out handling the basketball.
Well, they didn't yell at him very much this time, and he missed it. He seemed to concentrate better at the line when they were yelling at him. Not that it's quiet in here, and it rarely is quiet. Folks were here. We were here 2 hours before tip. They opened the doors about an hour and a half before tip, and the people in the top row were sitting down 90 minutes before the game.
This is a tremendous basketball atmosphere. Great fans. It's one of the reasons, in addition to having a good team and Greg Marshall and his staff doing an outstanding job, that it's so hard to win in here, and they've been so good over the years at Wichita State.
Berensma back into the game for Detroit. He's playing with four fouls, number 33 in red. They took out Boutte. Jake White, number 50, into the game for Wichita State in the gray. Token pressure, this is Wiggins. Malcolm Armstead played a magnificent game for the Shockers today. Wiggins, this is Hall. And good defense there by McCallum. Cut him off. He knows that Armstead's the lefty shooter. Got to shoot here. Well, that was good defense by the Titans. Police to cut this lead in half. And the rebound chased down by White. Armstead saw a gap, draws the whistle. Count it.
The biggest challenge for the Detroit defense in this half has been containing Malcolm Armstead's dribble penetration, whether it's in the half court or in transition as we see here. Nice change of pace. One of the things I like about it, if you're a young player watching this game, he had his head up the whole time as he attacked with his eyes on the rim.
McCallum does that so well, too, as I remember. Watch him play. These are two excellent, excellent guards. Substitutions now. Arupe back in, the big man, the seven-footer for Wichita State. Minerath taking what might be his last rest of the day for Detroit.
Armstead at the line with a chance to put up his 20th point, Dave. You want to talk about stepping up big in a big non-conference game.
And some pressure here. And they get it to the right guy. Edwards, look out! He went right after the seven-footer. You can sit down now, Darren.
That young man is fun to watch.
He knows it. He just went after him.
Now, like Arupe saying, no, not today. Not in our gym.
The only thing missing there was the Mutombo finger wave afterwards. Oh, that would have Anderson right at his average. So-so free throw shooter.
Dave,
one out of three.
Dave, if that one had gone down, it would have replaced the top 10 nominee from the first half, which was impressive.
I don't know how many times a guy has had two in the top 10, but yeah, the first one in the first half, you'll see it on SportsCenter, I promise. He'll check out Arupe, the shot blocker, and Hall will come back in after a short break.
Well, not his game, but his athleticism. I almost had a Dwayne Wade flashback from my times as an assistant at Marquette when D-Wade took off on a few of those.
Them both, and White with a good box out. McCallum tried to sneak in there. And Ashoe's the coach's son. He was calling the defense on the way back as relayed to him by his dad.
And we talked about it earlier in the half. The challenge has been offensively for Detroit. They've been good this half, but they haven't been able to get those stops that have been key in order to tie the game when they've gotten it down to a possession or two.
Under nine now in this game. It's been very exciting. Bracket Busters game. Williams can't get it. Hall almost got it. And Detroit comes the other way. Kaliste, McCallum, back to Kaliste. Kaliste in rhythm, no sir. Rebound, Edwards. We'll start over. And now McCallum has gotten the wheel back. Edwards. Oh my gosh, he just sort of made that up. Little wild shot, Bruinsman, no go. I gotta tell you, I've seen about 90 bodies on the floor for this game today. I'm so impressed with these two teams. I know Wichita, that's how they go. Detroit is trying everything they can to match what Wichita is bringing, and it's been so good to watch.
And I think in the second half they did that. We talked about after halftime, in the first half, Wichita State beat them to the 50-50 balls. They got them on the hustle plays. But in the second half, Detroit has closed that gap. Tremendous effort.
Wichita State led by 11 at the half. Detroit has been within three. McCallum, oh, that is pretty. Wow. So patient. He seems to play at a different speed. Not the fastest speed, just the comfortable speed for him.
Great pace.
Oof.
From Ray McCallum.
Anderson with a block shot and a hard fall, and the ball belongs to Detroit. That's not going over very well in snowy Wichita.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Ramada Worldwide. You do your thing, leave the rest to us.
Seconds. 10 seconds.
Right. Has this been entertaining in the Ramada Worldwide Bracket Busters here at Coke Arena on Wichita State? A lot of snow outside, as you saw, and a lot of hustle inside, Darren.
Well, we're getting really close to March, and there's a sense of urgency with these teams. How about this? This doesn't look like a loose ball. It looks like a fumble. Almost everybody on the floor. And then on the glass, chasing balls down. We've seen it from both teams this half, and it's been tremendous.
Well, it's been a kind of a tradition for Wichita State to participate in the Bracket Busters. A lot of the Valley schools have done it and done well for themselves. And those are some schools with great resumes and great runs and tournament appearances.
And those are all schools that over the years during these Bracket Buster games have gone on to the tournament and won games in the NCAA tournament.
And you don't want to see any of those teams in March if you're a fan, unless they're your team. Detroit playing thin today without Juwan Howard Jr. They've had to go to Bruinsma, who's got four fouls. Good defense there by White, right in the face of Minerath, and he lost it. Steal by Williams. Hall in his spot. That's where he goes to work. Down low. And off the Detroit turnover, Wichita State builds their lead back up to nine. Police stolen by Van Vliet. And a tough stretch suddenly for Detroit on offense. Two straight turnovers. Cotton, oh, the Euro step. Ray McCallum thought about a timeout. I think he's going to take one. Good luck being heard in the huddle. Well, Darren, this is the time of the year when a lot of schools are playing big conference games. But then you get the Bracket Buster games, a non-conference battle here between the Horizon League's Detroit Titans and the Missouri Valley Conference's Wichita State Shockers. Creighton plays tonight, and this game has featured unbelievable effort from both teams.
Well, both teams have done a great job, Dave, of getting on the floor, loose balls on the glass. There's been a lot of physical play in this one. You can tell that both these teams really want this game. It's what Bracket Busters does. It brings out the best in teams as we head into March.
Wichita State trying to get a 24th win. Detroit needs this for their tournament resume. It would be a tremendous win in this building especially. This place is unbelievable. Wichita State to score 81 doesn't happen very often. They're doing it the last minute with these steals.
Well, it's happened because of defense. Our last two baskets to extend this lead have started with good defensive play. You see Van Vliet literally just taking the ball away from Detroit. And then the nice finish on the other end by Cotton.
Minerath, he's made a couple from three, so has McCallum. But he's done a lot of damage on the inside. Off of White, Minerath. Tough little flipper, and he got it to go.
Minerath is a real matchup problem. He's 6'9". They bring him up. Stagger screens for threes, and he can drive the ball from the perimeter as well.
He gets buckets. He averages 14.8, and that seems low to me. He's at 55 his last couple of games, and you see he's over 20 this afternoon. Van Vliet in traffic. Williams ran into trouble, and he got fouled. And the common sound of another body hitting the floor with exactly 6 minutes to go. And there you go. According to that, Wichita State should now be an overwhelming favorite to win this game.
And a big reason for that is Greg Marshall's teams always defend so well, Dave, that if they can get a lead and put up big numbers like they have today, they're going to get stops down the stretch and they're going to make you play on the defensive end when the clock starts to get low.
That foul is on Nick Minerath. That's his second. Foul trouble, not really a big issue other than Bruinsma. Six fouls on Detroit and only four on Wichita State. It's kind of a game where the officials have kind of let them go. But nothing has been overtly physical. We've had bodies on the floor, but that's just hustle. One out of two. Hall seems to be around, and as soon as I say that, Minerath, with a move that would make Dana White and UFC happy, was able to help and get the rebound. McCallum. Bruinsma, even with the four fouls, aggressively going after the rebound, almost going into the bench. Minerath got clobbered. Edwards knocked out of his hands by Van Vliet.
And there's going to be a foul on the Shockers. Man. ESPN's Sunday afternoon showcase featuring a Big Ten battle. Brandon Paul and the Illini going on the road to face Trey Burke and those Michigan Wolverines. It's your Sunday afternoon showcase. Illinois versus number 7 Michigan. Sunday at 1 on ESPN and, of course, live on the Watch ESPN app. So Anderson at the line. Second foul on Van Vliet. And Anderson, we mentioned, a 49% free throw shooter. And he is now 1 out of 5. Back into the game, Kling Anthony early. Good shooter for the Shockers. And a rebound off those two missed free throws to Armstead. And Detroit really bad at the foul line today. 7 of 16. 5 of those misses coming from Edwards. Excuse me, Anderson. Six to shoot. From 3. That's to Kel Cotton, and all of a sudden it's a 13-point lead.
That's why that record is what it is when they score that many points, as we saw in the graphic, Dave, because they're going to make you work defensively when they get a lead down the stretch.
A little bit of a crisis here now for Detroit. They made the big second half comeback to beat Valpo in their last game last Saturday, but they're running out of time here. Knocked out of bounds off Van Vliet. It will be Detroit ball with 4:37 to go.
With the lead being 13, Detroit starting to get into some dangerous territory, Dave, with only 4:37 left on the clock.
Look what we have next up in Bracket Busters. Creighton and St. Mary's on ESPN. ESPN2 will be South Dakota State at Murray State, 8 Eastern. And stay up late on the East Coast to watch that Ohio-Belmont game at 10 o'clock on ESPN2. That's a good matchup. All of them are good. And this one has been, too. Don't let a 13-point advantage fool you. It has not been a 13-point kind of game. McCallum left open for 3. It's a 10-point game. Timeout, Detroit. Now Detroit will have only 1 left, plus the automatic inside of 4 minutes.
How good is Ray McCallum, Dave? He's the guy everybody wants to stop. He's got 27 right now.
Well, Wichita State, you go back to 2006, and this was the year of the upsets in the NCAA tournament. The Shockers did not shoot well against George Mason, coached by Jim Larrañaga. MVC player of the year that year was Paul Miller. He had 16 points and 9 rebounds. But George Mason, the 11 seed, beat the 7 seed in the Sweet 16 in Washington, D.C., 63-55. George Mason then went on to the Final Four where the Florida Gators knocked him off. We've seen some Bracket Buster participants, to play off what you said earlier, have gone to the Final Four 3 times.
Well, they've had tremendous success in the NCAA tournament, and doesn't really get much better than getting to the Final Four with the 3 teams you see highlighted.
And programs like Butler and Northern Iowa and